Hey guys, welcome back. So today I was cleaning up and I found some old CDs, so I thought it'd be a really good idea to paint over them. I needed some more decorations for my room, so I thought it'd be cute to play around and see what I could come up with. So I hope you enjoy. So I found like these old CDs, and obviously we don't really use them anymore. So what I've seen is that we can get a CD like this, and then if you get some sellotape, you want to get that strip, put it across the CD, and then rip it off. And then it becomes seafood. So I am currently looking on Pinterest for some inspiration, and I guess I'm just going to make, like, on a scrap piece of paper, some designs that I personally want to do. So here I'm just sketching out some koi fish on a piece of paper over the CD, so I knew like where I was painting and making sure that I wasn't going out of the lines. Then I'm using the On Around Me System 3 white acrylic paint. This acrylic paint was amazing. I'm also going in with the Winsor & Galleria acrylic paint. I got these as a set, and I'm also using this other white titanium that I got from Home & Bargains, which is a really cheap, affordable white paint that can really bulk up the colours when you really need to. So I didn't really use a palette, I usually use tin foil or paper, just because. Then I'm going in with a rounded brush and lightly going in with the mix of the colours, and using quite a dry painted brush and using the base colour to guide me of where like I'm painting, and it really just sits on top. So if you are doing a base coat, you really want to make sure that the white is quite flat so that you have a nice surface to work on. Then I'm going in with a darker red to shadow the outlines of the colour of the fish. I've also used masking tape here to secure the CV so it doesn't go anywhere. Now I'm also using black and washed down black to go over the centres of the colour of the koi. Then I'm using a thin brush to outline the details of the fish. I think using these types of brushes are really, really useful if you want to get straight, small, thin lines, but also you can control it a lot better. It also picks up quite a lot of paint so that you don't have to go and re-dip. You really want to be patient when doing this because it is really important to make sure that those lines that you are making are very precise and even. Then flipping over the CD, I have made some blue dots and light green seaweed. I just thought that would be nice to play around with the layers, and also because when I flip it over now, you can see it doesn't intersect with the actual fish and it actually looks like it's just floating on top, which I really like that effect. Next I'm going into painting some clouds. So this one I ripped half a CD. I really thought it would be nice to see what it would look like with part of the CD there and part not. Again, securing it with masking tape and then using the white acrylic paint to create a base for the clouds. This is just really freehand, you don't have to really be precise with this, and you want to use like a circular stippling motion to mimic the fluffiness of the clouds. Next, this is my favourite one, the butterfly. Now, a lot on the internet has been a lot of butterfly design, so I thought, why not try it on a CD? So I got images off Google to help me with the proportions of the butterfly. So I thought one would be looking nice on, like, standing in the centre of the CD. And you really want to be light with your sketching and like loose on the wrist. And it doesn't matter if it's not perfect because you won't be able to see it on the final CD anyway. Now I'm just mimicking some clouds of where I want to put them. Also, I thought it'd be nice because I felt like it was a bit bland if it was just two butterflies by themselves. Now I'm sorry for the camera angle here, my other camera died, so I had to switch up the camera angle because the tripod would not let me draw underneath it because it's just not like that type of tripod. So apologies for that. And then I'm just going to go in with a nice white base coat. Then I'm going in with the blue, and whilst the base colour is still a little bit wet, you can still blend the colours together. So I chose a blue butterfly. And as you can see then, I'm just adding white and blue going in opposite directions, making sure that they blend together in the middle, but also making sure that the core is more of a darker and then going lighter towards the outer wings. I think practicing these butterflies really allowed me to look at the proportions and shadings of like what direction the butterfly is going. And then again going in with a really thin brush with a black paint to outline the butterfly.
This is that one.